Sure.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to point out the fact how the wash tub underneath Rain's feet is moving, but Rain, the individual, is not moving. As a matter of fact, she is very stiff within the boat. Fascinating. What's going on, ladies and gents? Welcome back to another episode of Tales of Symphonia. In the last episode, we defeated Lord Magnius and then destroyed his base. We destroyed this human ranch and we set the captives free. But unfortunately, Magnius told Chocolat that Lloyd and Genus murdered her grandmother Marble. And while there is some truth to that, of course, Magnius twisted the truth, upset Chocolat, and now Chocolat is... she was taken away by this group of Desaians, and we have no idea where she is, but we better go ahead and continue on, you know? In time, we will find Chocolat, but we also have to continue our journey to release those seals, as is the Chosen's journey. Magnius, what is it, Lloyd? Those last things he said were kind of strange. You mean about being deceived? I wonder what he was deceived by. There's no way to know now. Oh, I know! What? No, what? Magnius thought the fake Chosen group was us! Ah, I see. Then everything would make sense. No, it doesn't. If that was the case, the imposters would have been killed by now. Just as Rain said, there's no way for us to know now. But Magnius is dead. Isn't that enough? Yeah, I guess so. Still, I really thought we'd figured it out. No, I think that you might need to think a little bit harder than that, Lloyd. But in all honesty, there's no way that we can find out what exactly he was talking about, what Lord Magnius was talking about. As I said, in the last episode, before we killed Lord Magnius, one of the last things that he said was that he was deceived. Talk about a cryptic message. What does that even mean? And those were the last things that Lloyd and his party heard. But will we be able to find out what exactly he meant when he said that he was being deceived? Tune in the next episode of Tales of Symphonia to find out. Just kidding. Oh, yes! Photon. Okay, this is the move that I was talking about. Okay? Remember how Killia, a few episodes ago, Governor General Dor's fake daughter, how she used a move called Dark Sphere? Well, Photon, as you saw, is very similar to Dark Sphere, except it is of the light element. So yeah, now Rain can actually attack people with magic spells. There you go. Not only can Genus do it, not only can Kratos do it, but now Rain can attack with her magic as well as heal us with her magic. After a long and dreadful battle with Lord Magnius, don't you think that it's only appropriate that we stop by the House of Salvation in order to restore our strength, our energy? Yeah, definitely, especially if we're going to end up level grinding a little bit later in this episode. Oh, maybe I just terrified you guys by saying that. No, 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 we're not sure if we're going to be spending time level grinding. Personally, I think that after that last battle with Magnius, that we are on a very good level. What I mean to say is that for this point of the game, even on hard difficulty, I think that our levels are good enough. And it looks like that Lloyd is the highest level, being at level 19. Surprisingly, now he is more powerful than Kratos. Yeah, that's right. Kratos is on level 18 and now Lloyd is on level 19. What you want, Kratos? Wait a second. What am I doing? My apologies, ladies and gentlemen. It completely slipped my mind that we need this Spiritua Statue in order to see the Book of Regeneration. And apologies again. I completely forgot that one priest had admitted to replacing the Spiritua Statue with a fake one. And that is, of course, because he brought it to they call it the Thota Geyser. And apparently, the statue had fallen into the Thota Geyser, so now we, the Chosen's party, have to acquire it. Say, Genus, was I wrong after all? Are you talking about Chocolat? Yeah. Don't worry. I'm sure she'll understand someday. I hope so. I really hope so too. I'm sure that if we had gotten to know Chocolat a little bit more, that she would have been great friends with the Chosen's party. You know, one thing that is really interesting in this game is how, remember when we first went to Palma Costa and we first met Chocolat and her family? Remember how her mother, you know, her mom, whose name I have a difficult time pronouncing, she mentioned that the store that she was running belonged to a person named Marble. And I feel like that gave a big hint as to the identity of these two young ladies. Of course, it means that they were most likely at least acquaintances, friends, or family relatives of Marble. But of course, now we know the truth. Let's take a look at this. Oh, how unusual. Are you actually going to pray? Although this is a tour boat boarding station, it is, in fact, a full-fledged house of salvation. After all, it's a place to pray. Thank you for your prayers. That was a very long-winded little monologue there. Hi, welcome. Okay, this is the most convenient, well, the only way to view the Thota Geyser. It will be 200 gold for a round trip? That's not bad. As a matter of fact, it makes me think that staying at the inn at Palma Costa is a complete ripoff. 200 gold for staying at the inn, and then 200 gold for a boat ride? Or no, actually, take a look at these. These are not boats. Yeah, they're wash tubs.
Well, it's a wash tub.
Wash tubs.
Wow, this looks like it'll be fun.
Of course, Colette looking on the positive side of things. For her, the glass is always half full.
I'm going to wait here. Go on ahead without me.
What's wrong, Professor Sage?
Nothing. I'm not getting in that thing.
It looks fun. Come on, let's get in.
Yeah, Rain.
Professor Sage, are you afraid of water or something?
I was just starting to say, this should be fun.
Sure.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to point out the fact how the wash tub underneath Rain's feet is moving, but Rain, the individual, is not moving. As a matter of fact, she is very stiff within the boat. Fascinating. It turns out that Rain is terrified of traveling in little wash tubs like this. Although, you know, thinking about it, I think I would be a little bit afraid to travel across the sea in a wash tub like this. But of course, it's the ocean that she's afraid of. That's what that cutscene was implying. You gotta learn how to analyze cutscenes the way that I do, guys. It's my analyzing, my cutscene analyzing skills are indeed very impressive, if you ask me. Aww, that was a rare experience. Seriously, who has like a touring business, okay? And they make the tourists travel across the sea in little wash tubs. And may I point out the fact that the tour guide was not even there with us to help us maneuver the thing. Then again, how difficult is it to maneuver in a wash tub? But if the waves were splashing and crashing, you know, I'm pretty sure it would have been dangerous. Wow! Lloyd, a geyser is a type of hot spring that periodically erupts with boiling water and water vapor. Yeah, I knew that. Yeah, he proved a few episodes ago that he knew that. I don't know why you're telling me that, Genus. Don't you guys get annoyed when people are like that? Where they explain something to you as if you didn't know it, and it makes you feel really dumb, and if anything, it just annoys you, you know? So now it looks like that Kratos and Colette are a little bit fascinated by this little area over here. All I have to do is to stop it with my magic, right? Yeah, while it's stopped, I'll go down there along the rocky parts and get the statue. The ice I can make will, well, it's just an estimate, but I don't think it'll last more than about 30 seconds. Gotcha. Lloyd, be careful. Don't do anything dangerous. Even my healing arts have their limits. You have a bad habit of getting cocky. Be careful. Whenever Lloyd is about to do something daring, you know, sometimes I feel like all the party can do is insult them. insult him. Move in the direction I indicate. If you mess up 3 times, the ice will melt, so don't make any mistakes, okay? Good luck, Lloyd. This is a little mini game that the game throws at you. But it's not difficult at all, so. As Gina said, he will guide us. Okay then, here I go. Up. Left, I'm guessing up again. No, left. Left. Whoa, I didn't expect him to jump all the way there. I thought he was going to take the easier way. But goal? Yeah, see, it's a mini game. It's not simply acquiring the Spiritua Statue, guys. It is a game where there was a goal. And the moment that you reached said goal, the crowd shouted, "Goal!" Okay then, let's go back to that old man. Spiritua Statue was found. Perfect, perfect. Now we can go back to that stingy old man, as Genus described him. Give him the Spiritua Statue. Wait a second. Now that I think about it, don't you think that it would be more appropriate for us to give it to the people in the House of Salvation? You know what? We need that Book of Regeneration. Say, this spiritual woman the statues are made after, she saved the world, right? That's right. Thanks to Spiritua, the world was filled with mana and the people were saved. And Spiritua was guided into heaven. If she already saved the world back then why is everyone suffering now with mana shortages and the designs? The world stopped receiving its blessing because the Tower of Salvation disappeared. That's what I was taught anyway. Lloyd, are you actually studying? Not really, it's just been bugging me. I just thought, since it's a tower, someone has to have made it, and someone has to be doing something with it, you know? Maybe angels like Remiel are providing us with mana. I see what you mean. That is a fascinating subject. Up until now, we've simply thought of the Tower of Salvation as nothing more than a symbol of salvation. In the end, the only way we'll find the answer is to complete the salvation of the world. When you become an angel, I wonder if you'll go to the Tower of Salvation too. If that's the case, we should just ask you after you go. I'm looking forward to your stories. Okay, sure. Those are really some legitimate questions that I think are definitely worth asking. Or you know what, but before we leave, why don't we talk to the NPCs a little bit? We kind of arrived at the Thota Geyser, got the Spiritua Statue, and now we're just about to leave, but I think that we should do at least a little bit of exploration. Even though this place isn't exactly the largest area in Silveront. It's interesting to see what these guys have to say, at least. This is the only hot spring in Silveront. It seems you used to be able to enter the water, but a new geyser sprang up and no one has been allowed to bathe in it ever since. Oh, by the way, did I share with you guys this little side quest where if you play as Colette in the overworld and then speak with dogs, then Colette will give each of the dogs names. She says, "This one feels like a Bob. His tail is so cute." And if you do that with every dog in the game, then something special will happen. Of course, I won't tell you right away what that is. You guys have to figure it out yourselves. In all honesty, I'm not even sure if I'm going to be doing this in this playthrough because it's honestly a pain to do it, I feel. So just a pro tip. If you ever see a dog in the overworld or in any town, city, or anything like that, be sure that you immediately start playing as Colette and just speak with the dog. Ah, let's see. Approximately 200 years ago, the Thota Geyser... What about the Thota Geyser? Ah, let's see. Approximately 200 years ago, the Thota Geyser... You're not completing your sentence there. The Thota Geyser, approximately 200 years ago... Okay... Wait, let me say something besides just what's written on the sign. Yeah, you see, that's exactly what I'm thinking right now too. Even if you could go into the hot spring, there's no one that would go in there with all these people staring at them. That's true. You know how it is. Whenever you go into a hot spring, you are completely nude. Oh, so there's actually a Photoshop here. Nice, but there's not really anything all that new here. Yeah, a bunch of essential items that we should have, but I feel like our amount of apple gels, life bottles, are satisfactory for the moment. Let's just buy one more magic lens so that we can make that amount 15. The total amount of magic lens is 15. So it doesn't look like there's anything else here. We just didn't speak with this lady. Let's see. No, sorry, that's not a lady, that's a dude. I'm currently researching whether the hot water that erupts from the geyser can be put to some sort of practical use. That would be interesting if you could find some way to put it to some practical use. Other than that, it looks like there's really nothing else here. So you know what? I will see you guys back at Hakonesia Peak so that we can give this spiritual statue to the old man, the cranky old man, and then view the Book of Regeneration. So I will see you guys then. Cranky old man! Cranky old man, stingy old man, look what we've got for you, Coton! Oh, this is indeed the spiritual statue. Give it to me! Wow. So hasty. In exchange for the Book of Regeneration. I know. Just be sure you remember, I'm only letting you look at it. How is that fair? Ah, wonderful. Now you may look at the Book of Regeneration as much as you like. Alright. Let's start reading it right away. At least he's not limiting us to view it only once, you know? It's written in a very old style. What does it say? There's quite a lot of text. Colette, please read aloud just the parts that concern the seals. Okay, I'll skip over the torn parts. Raging flames in an ancient city deep within clouds of sand overlook the city, lighting the darkness. Pure flowing water floating, overflowing in an isolated land, becomes a giant pillar and rains down from the sky. Sublime wind, ancient city, the world's enshrined in the center of a giant stone seal lurks evil, impersonating a holy force. Shining, gazing up at the summit of the gods, giving praise to the pillar of the world. From the top of the tower of ancient god, too giant. The rest is too damaged, I can't read it. Then we don't even know how many seals are left? Indeed. The raging flames part at the beginning must be the seal of fire, right? What do the other parts mean? Pure water overflows in an isolated land and becomes a giant pillar. It is likely that means that the seal of water is at the Thota Geyser. The seal of wind must be the Asgard ruin. If we travel to Asgard, we should be able to find some clues. What about gazing up at the summit of the gods? I think that's probably the Tower of Mana. From there, you can see the mountains around the Tower of Salvation, so that's probably the summit of the gods. But what seal is that? I don't know. Oh well. At any rate, we know where the seals are now. Let's get going. Thanks, Gramps. Thank you so much. Come back whenever you like, if you want to look at it again. Okay. So, now he doesn't seem as stingy. I haven't found any interesting artifacts lately. It's been quite boring. Well, yeah, at least he's not being so rude. Now that he actually got what he wanted, you're telling me that you're only going to respect me if we give you what you want? Wow, selfish. The angelic language is pretty difficult. Really? Yeah, I don't really understand what was written, or I didn't really understand what was written. I read nothing but books written in angelic language since I was a child, so I wonder if I could learn to read it if I study. The angelic language is the basis for the language of this world. The grammar hasn't changed significantly. Yeah, I'll teach you if you'd like. I can provide some instruction as well. Okay, I'm going to learn it! Wow, I love Genus's motivation there, okay? That is the right attitude to have about learning. Being excited about it. Being excited to gain and retain new knowledge about the world, you know? Genus is such an awesome kid for that. But anyway, now that we know the location of some of the seals, I think it's time that we go ahead and head to some of those locations, don't you say? But we're going to have to do that in the next episode. So thank you guys for tuning in. If you enjoyed the episode, please don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. And if you'd like to follow our walkthrough or our playthrough of Tales of Zestiria live, be sure to go ahead and head over to twitch.tv/ShadowJ and hit the follow button so that you can be notified of when we go live over there. Thank you guys once again. I will see you in the next episode of Tales of Symphonia. But until then, take care.